In this series, I aim to give you a quick introduction to some of the common plant families found in the UK. Learning to identify plant families is a great help in identifying individual plant species you come across. If you know the family, then you know where to start looking for the species in a guide. And identifying the family is an achievement in itself. Plants are classified into families based on characteristics that they share. This is then narrowed down further into genera and then into species. So, the way to identify a plant's family is to know these characteristic features. Here we're going to look at the Geraniaceae, the geranium family. This is a family of herbaceous plants and sub-shrubs, found mainly in temperate and subtropical parts of the world. There are around 800 species, which are either annuals or perennials. The common garden plants in the genera Geranium and Pelargonium are in this family. Aside from use as ornamental plants, essential oil used in perfume and cosmetics is extracted from some Pelargonium. In the UK, there are quite a few species in the Geraniaceae to be found outside the garden. Most of these are in the genus Geranium, though you can also find species of Erodium, and most are native. So, how do you know if you're looking at a plant in this family? The flowers of Geraniaceae are actinomorphic, meaning they're irregular in shape, basically round and symmetrical in more than one direction. They're also open in shape. The flowers have 5 petals, usually in shades of pink or purple, sometimes blue or white. The petals are not joined together. They are separate or free, as are the 5 sepals behind them. The stamens are in multiples of 5. Most often there are 10, arranged in 2 whorls of 5. The 5 carpels, which will become the fruit and bear the seeds, are joined together into a beak shape. Although they're joined, the stigmas of the flower give them away. There are 5. The ovaries of the carpels are superior, which means they are attached above the rest of the floral parts, the stamens, petals and sepals. Once the flower is pollinated, which is done by insects, the fruit develops into a needle or beak shape, which is where the common names of crane's bill for geranium and stork's bill for erodium come from. These dry fruits split open at the joins to release the seeds. Leaves of Geraniaceae are arranged alternately on the stems, and they have a distinctive structure called a stipule where they join onto the stem. These resemble little leaves. The leaves themselves are lobed or divided and often palmate, like this Geranium pratense and Geranium lucidum. Erodium, like Erodium sicuterium, have pinnate leaves. The stems tend to be hairy to varying degrees, along with the carpels and sometimes the leaves. So, if the plant you're looking at has open 5-petaled flowers in pink or purple, with 10 stamens in 2 whorls, dry fruit in the shape of a beak, and stipules at the base of the palmate or pinnate leaves, then it's probably in the Geraniaceae. Keep an eye out for these 3 species. Geranium robertianum, which has small pink flowers and distinctively smelling divided leaves. Geranium pratense, with large purple-blue flowers and lobed leaves. And the non-native Geranium perennicum, which has smallish pink-purple flowers and lobed leaves.